Look at this fifth question now. X Corporation has estimated that for a new product, its break-even point is 2,000 units. And 2,000 units, if the item is sold for rupees 14 per unit, that means if you are selling your product at rupees 14 per unit, the break-even point should be 2,000 units. The company has currently identified variable cost of rupees 9 per unit. Okay, now calculate the degree of operating leverage for the sales volume of 2,500 units and also 3,000 units. That means on the if you look at this first line, they are manufacturing a new product. Its break-even point is 2,000 units. That means they want to sell break-even. Break-even means number of units sold. So as there is no profit, no loss. That is known as break-even sales. Break-even point. Point means in number of units. In terms of units he is talking about. Okay. So break-even point 2,000 units means if he is selling 2,000 units, then there would be no profit, no loss. Okay. So one, 2,000 units. Second, 2,500 units are sold. And if third, 3,000 units are sold. So we need to calculate operating leverage. Only operating leverage. That's it. Okay. And if the sales volume is 2,500 units and 3,000 units, will there be any difference? He's asking you. So now we need to calculate. Okay. Let's start. See, we need to make income statement. There are three units to be sold. Three different segregations are made for 2,000 units, for 2,500 units, and for 3,000 units. Means, if company is selling 2,000 units, what will be my earnings before interest and tax? If I sell 2,500 units, then what company will be able to have profit, gain profit? And if company is selling 3,000 units, what profit will company earn? So he's asking you that. And what will be my DOL, that is degree of operating leverage in each of these situations? Is that clear? This much is clear, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, how do we need to solve it? Just a minute. See, first you have to make a column for particulars, then per unit column, and then three amount columns. Amount column has to be divided into three parts. Why? Because three different in number of units are to be sold in the market. For 2,000 units, amount column. For 2,500 units, amount column. And for last 3,000 units, amount column. Okay. Now sales. Sales per unit is given 14 rupees. Sales per unit is given 14 rupees. So here you will write 14 rupees. Okay. And this 14 rupees has to be multiplied with each of them. With 2,000, with 2,500, with 3,000. So as to get the amount column of sales for each of them. See, 14 into 2,000, how much it would be? 28,000. 14 into 2,500, how much it would be? 35,000. And 14 into 3,000, it would be 42,000. Is it clear, everybody, this much? This much is clear for everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now what we have to do? Yeah. Now what we have to do? Less variable cost. Deduct variable cost from sales. So what is my variable cost? 9 per unit. It is already stated, you know. So 9 per unit is already there. Okay. Now I will write here 9 per unit. So 9 will be multiplied with 2,000. I will get 18,000 variable cost in first case. 9 into 2,500. 22,500 variable cost in second case. And 9 into 3,000. I will get 27,000 in third case. So all the variable cost will be deducted from the sales of each of these items. Now I will get contribution 10,000, here 12,500, here 15,000. Now listen and listen very carefully, very very carefully. Now after contribution, what do I do always? You tell me, after contribution, what do I do? What is the next step to be done? Come on, tell me quickly.
Less fixed cost.
Very good, very good. Less fixed cost. Now, is fixed cost given in the question? Look at the question only. Don't look at the solution part. Only look at the question and you tell me whether fixed cost is given in the question or not. Yes or no? Just give me the answer. Come on, quickly. There are four lines of the question and we have already read the question. So by reading, have you noticed any fixed cost given in the question?
No,
fixed cost is not given. Then how do I get EBIT then? If I don't get EBIT, how will I apply a degree of operating leverage? Because the formula of operating leverage is contribution upon EBIT. If there is no EBIT, then how will I apply the degree of leverage formula? Now, if I don't have fixed cost, how will I come to conclusion of EBIT? Can anybody tell me how to calculate fixed cost? In the first case, look at the first.
Ma'am, फिर हम लोग sign change करते हुए
sign को ठीक है करेंगे.
Bottom line से top label पे जाएंगे तो फिर मिल जाएगा.
Very good, very good, very good. चलो आपने एक hint दे दी सबको. Now she has given the hint to everyone that we need to go from bottom to upwards, from bottom to top, from lower side to upper side. We need to do opposite way. But to do opposite way, we need to have at least one thing. No. See, you have only sales and variable costs. Look at the first column of 2000 units. Don't go to 2500 and 3000. You are thinking about 2000 units for which information is given here. Selling price is 14 per unit. Variable cost is 9 per unit. So you have calculated contribution also. Now, if you don't have fixed cost, how will you calculate EBIT? And if you want to go from bottom to top, you will have to have EBIT at least. You will have to have at least EBIT, no? So EBIT, if EBIT is there, only then my EBIT will be deducted from contribution and then I will get fixed cost as my balancing figure. But I don't have EBIT also. Look at the question. Do I have EBIT? Look at the question. Do I have EBIT in the case of 2000 units?
No, ma'am.
Who is answering no? Anu? Think twice and tell me. Do we have EBIT in first case of 2000 units? In first case of 2000 units, do we have EBIT? Please think twice and tell me yes or no. Yes, we have EBIT. It is hidden somewhere. You need to find out. It is hidden in a word which is given in the first line. Chalo, come on. I have given you a hint now. Come on. Read out the first line again. X Corporation has estimated that for a new product, its break-even point is 2,000 units.
I'm 2,000 units.
Wait. For 2,000 units, I want EBIT. So what is EBIT? Bacha, it is break-even point. I have already given you a hint when I was starting the question. When I was starting the question, I already given you a hint. Break-even point means no profit, no loss.
No loss.
Yes. A situation where you have no profit, no loss. Therefore, EBIT is given. EBIT means earning before interest and tax, means profit. No, it is my profit. Earnings means profit. Profit before interest and tax. I do have it. You cannot say, no, ma'am, we don't have EBIT. We have EBIT. EBIT is zero because he says it is break-even point of 2,000 units. when we are going to sell 2000 units in the market at the rate 14 per unit, there will be no profit, no loss. That means break even point. So break even point word is very, very, very important here. Very important. Without which you will not be able to understand what is break even point. Without which you will not be able to understand the amount of EBIT. So EBIT is zero. Zero is given in the question. Zero is given in the question. Now what Anu said earlier has to be applied. Anu said we have to go from bottom to top. Ulta jane ka. Ulta jane ke liye sign change karna padta hai. We need to change the sign. Okay. But here we don't have fixed cost. No. We don't have fixed cost. So no need to change the sign of less into add. We need to find out fixed cost. Isn't it? We need to find out fixed cost. So to find fixed cost, we have contribution. Yes. 10,000. We have EBIT. Yes. Zero. So 10,000 minus zero. Find out the difference between the two. We will get fixed cost. Tell me, 10,000 minus zero is how much? Zero or 10,000?
10,000
minus zero is zero. Sometimes students are so worried while writing their exams. They are so worried. They are so stressful that they write 10,000 minus zero is zero. Oh my God.
No, ma'am, you cannot write it that. Zero.
Yeah. So 10,000 minus zero is 10,000. So we have found out fixed cost. It's so simple. You just have to see break even point. This word gives you the answer of EBIT. This is break even point means no profit, no loss. When it is no profit, no loss means EBIT is zero. Nothing. Nothing means zero. Whenever we earn nothing, it means zero. Okay, if it is zero and contribution is 10,000, so middle part we will be having as balancing figure. So 10,000 minus zero, we will have 10,000 as fixed cost. Did you understand this much? 10,000 in the first case. In the first case. Now you tell me, what is this 10,000? 10,000 is variable cost or fixed cost? Come on, tell me quickly. Variable or fixed?
Fixed cost.
Now, fixed cost means what? Fixed in every situation. Whatever you produce 2,000 units, fixed cost will be 10,000. If you produce 2,500 units, fixed cost still will be 10,000. If you produce 3,000 units, the fixed cost still will be 10,000 only. Fixed cost means same in every production run. In every production capacity, whatever you produce less or you produce more, fixed cost will remain constant. So here in the first case, look at the first case, 2000 units. You have found out the fixed cost as balancing figure 10,000. Now this 10,000 will be written here as 10,000, also here as 10,000. Now what you will do? We have already calculated contribution of 2,500 units and we have already calculated contribution of 3,000 units also. What you will do? Contribution minus fixed cost, you will get profit 2,500. Here in the third case, contribution 15,000 minus fixed cost 10,000, you will get profit 5,000 units. Rupees. Now you have got EBIT. You have got contribution. I think now it is good to apply DOL formula. DOL is degree of operating leverage, contribution upon EBIT. So here you will write 10,000 upon zero. You have to write this way, the way they have written here. You have to write here, 10,000 is contribution divided by zero is EBIT. So 10,000 divided by zero, answer will be? Anything you divide by zero, answer will be? Answer will be what? Does any number come there? Or do we have zero answer? 10,000 divided by zero is what?
Zero.
Zero. Anything you divide by zero will be zero. Therefore, answer is nil. So you need to write it. They have not written. You need to write it. 10,000 डिवाइड बाय जीरो आंसर विल बी जीरो. ईयर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इज 12,500 डिवाइड बाय ईबीआईटी इज 2,500. सो 12,500 डिवाइड बाय 2,500 आंसर विल बी 5. एंड हियर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इज 15,000 ईबीआईटी इज 5,000. सो 15,000 बाय 5,000 आंसर इज 3. ओके सो इफ यू सी विच वन इज बेटर like how many units should you sell in the market? 3000. Why? Because DOL is lesser in that case, and the lesser DOL, the better the company's profits. If you can check, the profits is also more in this case. Here the profit is zero, here the profit is 2500, and here it is literally doubled, 5000. Here it was zero and here it is 5000, the double of 2500. So it is good to sell 3000 units because the profit is more and DOL is less. Should be less, no? Degree, any type of degree of leverage, whether it is operating leverage, whether it is financial leverage, it should be less. Okay, if it is less, it is good for company. It is ideal situation. Humne pehle seekha na last sum mein. In last sum we have understood that high operating leverage combined with high financial leverage will constitute a risky situation. It should not be high. If one of them is low and other one is high, it is okay. Means normal situation. But if you want to have an ideal situation, best situation, both leverages should be low. So operating leverage, if it is low, then it is good for the company. Are you getting my point?
Yes, ma'am.
So how note has to be written? With increase in sales volume from 2500 units to 3000 units, if you are increasing the number of units from 2500 to 3000, operating profit is doubled. See, operating profit was 2500 here, but it is now doubled to rupees 5000. And operating degree of operating leverage is also less in case of 3000 units. So for company, to produce and sell 3000 units is better, is more preferable. This is the way you need to write. Come on, do it. I'm giving you 5 minutes. Please write down together with the note. Okay, write down. Okay, I hope you all have written note also. This note has to be written, huh? We will do these questions, situation 1 and 2, but not now. I will teach you maybe tomorrow. Now see this question. This question. Calculate the degree of operating leverage, degree of financial leverage, and degree of combined leverage from the following firms and interpret the results. There are three firms now. A firm, company B, and company C. Output in units means number of units produced and sold. 60,000 for A company, 15,000 for B company, 1 lakh for C company. Fixed cost is given for all three of them. Variable cost per unit is given 0.20, 1.50, 0.02. Interest on borrowed capital is 4,000 for company A, 8,000 for company B, and nil for C. Means C doesn't have any borrowed funds. Selling price per unit is 0.60 per unit, huh? 5.00 per unit for B company and 0.10 for C company. First, you need to make the statement. In statement only, we will find all the formulas. It will be better for us and easy also. How many columns? Particulars, column A, column B, column C. But you need to divide column A, column B, column C into two parts. Per unit and amount. Per unit and amount. Again, per unit and amount. Is this much clear to everyone? This
yes,
much
ma'am.
Is clear? Yeah. Now see, sales. First of all, sales. Selling price is 0.60. So here you will write 0.60. Number of units of A. how many units are produced? A, 60,000. So here you will write 60,000. For B, 15,000. For C, 1 lakh units. So you need to write it here, because again and again by looking at the question, you'll get confused. So you need to write down here, okay? For A, it is 60, for B, it is 15, and for C, it is 1 lakh. Now sales per unit is 0.60. So what you will multiply with? I mean, what you will multiply 0.60 with so as to get the amount of sales of A company?
With 60,000.
Very good. So 0.60 per unit into 60,000 units. So 36,000 will be your answer. Similarly, we have to do it for B and C. 5 per unit will be multiplied with 15,000, and 0.10 will be multiplied with 1 lakh. With its own units. एक दूसरे के साथ नहीं करना है, जिसका जो है, with its own number of units, like B has its own number of units 15,000, C has its own 1 lakh units, so it has to be multiplied accordingly, okay? Less variable cost. What is variable cost per unit? 0.20. So again same, 0.20 into 16,000. You have for B 1.50, so 1.50 into 15,000. And last is 0.02. So 0.02 into 1 lakh, you will get variable cost. Likewise, you will have, after deducting, the variable cost has to be deducted from sales, you will get contribution. Fixed cost is already given. 7200 for A, 14,000 for B, and 1500 for C. You just have to copy down. 7200. 14,000, 1500. Similarly, you will get EBIT. After deducting fixed cost from contribution, you will get EBIT. Less interest. After EBIT, we are supposed to deduct interest on borrowed capital. So first case, we have 4,000. Second, we have 8,000. Third is nil. Same, we will copy down. Less interest, 4,000, 8,000. And last case, nil. So we will get EBT, earnings before tax. Okay, EBIT minus interest, we will get EBT. And that will be your answers. 12,800, 30,500, 6,500. Now, how you need to do? You do not have to close the table. No, in this table only, you have to calculate all the three formulas. Can you see in the table? DOL, DFL and DCL. Formula is written only once. Contribution upon EBIT in the particulars column. DFL is equals to EBIT upon EBT in the particulars column. And same way, DCL is equals to contribution upon EBT. Now, whatever figures are, respective figures are, you will put it in the formula and find out the answer. Just as I will show you DOL. Suppose DOL. Let us calculate all the DOL of all the companies. A. What is the formula of DOL, contribution upon EBIT? So for A, what is contribution? 24,000. What is EBIT? 16,800. So here you will write 24,000 divided by 16,800. Answer will be 1.42. There only. In that same box. Now, as soon as it is over, you draw a line here so that it doesn't look clumsy. Okay, it should be neat and clean, just as you see it on the screen. Okay, contribution upon EBIT for B. So what is contribution? 52,500 divided by EBIT 38,500. So divide both of them, you'll get the answer. Draw a line to show the transaction that the formula is over. Just as they have also drawn a line here. Can you see a line below DOL? So right from beginning till the end, they have stretched the line. And then they have started doing DFL. So DFL is over, stretch a line again, and then start doing DCL. So it will look, very neat and clean. Okay. Is it clear, everybody? Will you write it now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Note down the solution part. I'm giving you 5-7 minutes. Do it. डू इट नीट एंड क्लीन वे प्लीज, डोंट आई मीन रब एंड देन कट, डोंट डू ऑल दीज थिंग्स, ओके? सो डू इट वेरी नीट एंड क्लीन वे, टेक योर टाइम, आई एम गिविंग यू टाइम, राइट इट प्रॉपरली.